In this video, I will show you how to check a microwave oven transformer. I have a Samsung microwave oven. It has a grill. Now let's put a glass of water in it and try to start it. It definitely smelled like something was heating up, but the water did not heat up. To disassemble the microwave oven, first you need to disconnect the power supply and unscrew one side screw.
And five rear ones. Slide the cover back a little and remove it.
As we can see, after 30 seconds, the water did not heat up, but the transformer is hot and smoke is coming from it. It is necessary to figure out why the high current transformer is heating up. To check why the transformer is heating up, it might be due to the magnetron. We will disconnect the magnetron and start the microwave oven on heat. After that, we will see if it starts smoking. We see that the transformer is smoking again. Our problems are with the transformer or the high current capacitor. On the bottom of the microwave oven, there are three mounting bolts for the transformer. We unscrew them. This transformer consists of a primary and a secondary winding. First, we will check the primary winding. For this, we take a multimeter, set the switch to 200 ohms, and check the primary winding. Connect the two probes to the terminals of the primary winding. Right now it shows 3 ohms. We know that the normal range is from 2 to 4.5 ohms, depending on the transformer's power. So the primary winding is in order. Now let's check if there is a short of this winding to ground. In order to do this, very carefully strip the dielectric lacquer from one very specific spot on the outer casing of the transformer and then place one contact very securely on the ground and the other contact very precisely on the winding terminal. The multimeter does not respond at all, which means there is no short to ground in the primary winding. After this, we will check the secondary winding. For this, set the multimeter to 2000 ohms. The normal resistance of the secondary winding should be between 140 and 350 ohms. Now, connect one probe to the secondary winding and the other to the ground, which we have cleaned. And we just look at the readings. The reading is 406 ohms. This already exceeds the required standards, which means there is interturn resistance present. Now, let's test the transformer under 220 volts. For this, I will connect the 220 volt terminals to the primary winding and connect it to the electrical circuit. It's not loaded right now. Let's check. It started to hum. It's in idle mode. There's no load on it.
Slowly started to smoke. It came hot.
You can see that it started to smoke. The solution is simple. It means it has a turn-to-turn short circuit and is faulty. It will need to be replaced.